Hi friends, in today's lecture we'll discuss about cascade form realization of IIR filter. Now in previous couple of lectures we have seen direct form 1 and direct form 2 realization of IIR filter. Now coming to the point of what is meant by cascade form realization. So basically cascade form realization is nothing but here several IIR systems are connected in cascade with each other. That means they are connected in series with each other. Now let us consider an IIR filter with the transfer function as H of Z. Now this H of Z is divided into several systems. They are connected in series with each other. Let the first one is H1Z into H2Z into H3Z. So on. I am connecting the last system with the transfer function as HNZ. You can see it here, all the systems are connected in series with each other, that means they are multiplied with each other. In another form we can write simply, let this is my first system whose transfer function is H1Z, having input as X1 of N and its corresponding output we will consider Y1 N. This is our first system transfer function H1Z. Now we'll cascade this with H2Z. So this is the block of H2Z. Now here simply output of first system works as input of the next system. Similarly, output of second system becomes input to the next system as H3Z and so on to the last system if we assume as HNZ and its corresponding output becomes Y of N. That means several systems are connected in series with each other. Now in order to realize this for IIR filter, simply we have to use direct form 2 realization and these systems can be connected in series. So let us take one example on this. You can see here the question is obtain cascade form realization of this system transfer function. Now as far as this example is considered, we'll divide this in two different systems. Let this entire segment we'll assume as H1Z into this entire segment we'll consider as H2Z. And then by direct form 2 realization we'll cascade them with each other. That means first I am assuming that H1Z is equal to 1 plus 3 by 2 Z inverse plus 1 by 2 Z raised to minus 2 divided by 1 plus Z inverse plus 1 by 4 Z raised to minus 2, whereas H2Z is 1 minus 3 by 2 Z inverse plus Z raised to minus 2. It is divided by 1 plus 1 by 4 Z inverse 1 by 2 Z raised to minus 2. Now we'll first realize this using direct form 2, then it is cascaded with realization of this transfer function. So as far as this is considered, if you see, we need two delay elements, namely Z inverse and Z raised to minus 2. So by the same procedure, we'll write this. Here I will write all pole system and this side will write all zero system. So starting with this, we'll introduce the delay. Let this is X1N as we are realizing H1Z. And this corresponding output will consider as Y1N only for this system. So first this all pole system first coefficient is 1, we'll consider this as 1. Then we need delay elements. So this is my first delay element as Z inverse. Now this Z inverse is multiplied with 1. So let this is multiplied with 1. Next it is Z raised to minus 2. That means we'll take the same term and we'll add one more delay element that becomes Z raised to minus 2. Now this is multiplied with 1 by 4. So this is multiplied with 1 by 4. Now we need two adders, 1 and 2. So this is plus and this one is plus and they are being added. Now as I already told you, the only difference between direct form 1 and direct form 2 is what? The arrangements of delay elements as well as pole coefficients. If they are positive they becomes negative and if they are negative they becomes positive. So here you can see this is plus and plus, so So it should be minus 1, and this is minus 1 by 4. Now we'll come across all zero system. First, this is 1, so we'll take this as 1. Next, z inverse is multiplied with 3 by 2, so we'll get z inverse from here. It is multiplied by plus 3 by 2. Z is 2 minus 2 is multiplied by plus 1 by 2. So this is multiplied by plus 1 by 2. Now we need two adders. This is first plus and final element we'll take in a similar fashion. Let instead of this, we'll consider this is y1. Yeah, that is output of this system. Now we'll realize h2z in the similar fashion, and we'll cascade with this one. You can see again we need two delay limits for numerator as well as denominator. So let us take this y1n as it is, and here we'll add z inverse, first delay limit, which is multiplied with plus 1 by 4. So if it is plus, it becomes minus 1 by 4. This is z is 2 minus 2. This is z inverse. Now it is multiplied with minus 1 by 2. Again, we need two adders. So let them, let this is plus, this one is plus, and they'll be added. Now we'll come across numerator terms. So first coefficient is 1, that means this is 1. Now next, z inverse is multiplied with minus 3 by 2. So here we'll get z inverse. Now it is multiplied with minus 3 by 2. And z is 2 minus 2 is multiplied with 1. So this is multiplied with 1. Again, we need two adders. So we'll cascade, or simply we'll arrange them. And this is our y2. Now these two systems are connected in series with each other. That means output of first system becomes input to the next system. So we'll take this line and we'll connect as an input to the next system, and this becomes cascade form realization of the given transfer function or IR system as h of z.